This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We are excited this morning. It is a glorious day because Jesus is on the throne. Hallelujah. And he is our soon coming King. Hallelujah. He'll return back in the clouds. Hallelujah. We are excited in Jesus' name because we are helping. We are building the church in Jesus' name. We are expanding the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Jesus' name. We're not playing church. We are the church this morning. We are those, hallelujah, that believe unto the saving of our souls. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Welcome to Christian Revival Center here in Toms River, New Jersey. We are just excited this morning to be with you. Thank you so much for tuning in this morning. We just want to worship God to you with you this morning. We want to listen to the word of the Lord for this moment, for this season this morning. And we're just excited for what we have in store for you as we worship together this morning. Everybody just focus this morning. Tune out everything else around you. Make sure it's all quieted down so that you can get into his presence with us as people begin to sign in and just tune into a Christian Revival Center this morning. We just want to worship him and give him glory and honor this morning as we just thank him for who he is and for what he's doing in our lives. In Jesus' name, hallelujah.
Champion, giants fall when you stand undefeated. Every battle you won, and I am who you say I am. You crown me with confidence. I am seated in the heavenly place, undefeated with the one who has conquered it all. When I lift my voice and shout, every wall comes crashing down. I have the authority Jesus has given me. Giants fall when you stand undefeated.
So make sure you stay tuned. Hit the share button. Get the message out. It's going to be a powerful teaching today. I'm coming to you today talking about discerning of spirits and the spiritual gift of discernment. I'm coming as not only an apostle, but a prophet and a teacher today. And you're going to want to share this message.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God, glory to God. Well, we welcome you. We welcome you this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Christian Revival Center here in Toms River, New Jersey. And we just thank God for joining us this morning. You can see us every Sunday at 10:30. We will continue to... such we'll have to have in place and whatnot, but we're going to continue to preach the word. We're going to continue to minister by the power of the Holy Spirit. People will continue to be healed, delivered, set free, strengthened and empowered in their inner man. And we just thank God that his word is not bound, nor is his spirit bound, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Facebook Live will continue, as well as on Thursday evenings, Mark and Melissa and John Frieda will continue on Thursday evenings through Mark Turner Facebook. So look out for new special announcements on that, but this Thursday they will continue with that as well. So just continue to tune in. It's been phenomenal. The response and the people that have been tuning in have been getting so blessed and healed and delivered. And God is just moving through that their house right there in their own home with their son. And it's just awesome what God is doing in that little setting there, just with the few of them, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Also, we want to thank you all for your... In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you that the enemy touches them not. In the name of Jesus, the devourer is rebuked from their lives, in Jesus' name. And we thank you, Lord God, that you receive all the praise, the honor, and the glory, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
For those that just tuned in, we want to just make this announcement a second time. Next Sunday, Father's Day, our Heavenly Father's Day, CRC will be opening their doors. We will go with guidelines, and we'll be sending them out this week as to what the guidelines and restrictions will be, but there's no restrictions in the Holy Ghost, and we're going full force back into the ministry the Lord has placed into our hands. So we thank you, the faithfulness that you have had during this time to not only sow your tithes and your offerings and kept the doors open. We will continue having our live CRC broadcast on Facebook and also on YouTube. So if you cannot attend in church, if you're still social distancing, if you have reasons why you cannot yet come, it's absolutely not going to be a problem, because we will still be coming into your homes live on Facebook and YouTube. So you will not miss us either way, whether you're here in person or whether you're at home watching. We will continue to bring you CRC Facebook Live. That's one of the blessings of what has happened during the quarantine, is it moved us and pushed us into a new level of being able to bring the word of the Lord to you and to put us into your homes. And we've gone global. So thank you, God, for what he has done. Our attendance and those that are watching has quadrupled in this season. We've been reaching people in many, many other countries. So God has a purpose in everything, and all things work together for the good. We thank you for your faithfulness. You can give online on our website at ChristianRevivalCenterNJ.com, or you can mail it in, or we'll see you next week right here. God bless you. Apostle John, how are you today?
I'm awesome. Great. It's awesome. It's prayer is just so awesome when the anointing of God hits and then you just begin to pray. And truly miss that, doing that this in the, here in the sanctuary with the saints and those who just come in and want to release God's prayers that he's imparted unto us. It's just an awesome time, and got a little taste of it again this morning of how God moves when we come together. And we just thank God for that. Again, we'll be sending you emails, and look out Facebook about the announcements and procedures and such. And the message this morning, I'm excited about that. I know it's going to be a two-parter. She did tell me that. So it will be in two parts. And, you know, the scripture tells us that he gave us gifts to profit with all, so that we all can be blessed and encouraged and built up from them. And the discerning of spirits, which Apostle will be ministering to this morning, is so much needed. She's done that. She's pre-ministered that before. But there's different layers that have been added to it, I am sure. And it is this season that we just need to be so in tune as to who is saying what and what motivation is behind what is being said, so that we can rightly know who we are to follow and who we are not to follow, and encourage those that are following the wrong to know why what we're saying, what we're doing by the Spirit of God. So take notes and just let the Holy Spirit give you ears to hear this morning. Let's pray right now. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that we have ears to hear, Lord God, what the Spirit of God is saying to us this day, Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, that we hear so that we can do and begin to activate, Lord God, what we hear, Father. In Jesus' name, I thank you for the anointing that'll be ministered, Father, through this airwave this morning and through the replays, Lord God, that people will have a keen spirit, Lord God, about them, Lord God, by the Holy Spirit, Lord God, to discern and to know, Father, in Jesus' name, that they will be wise, Father, in Jesus' name, in this arena, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Are we ready for
We're ready for worship. Glory. Don't go away. We've got awesome worship with our own John Frieda and Melissa Turner. And the other part of the Turner family is here, and he's distracting me, not my son, but my grandson. So I want to call them up here. I just want to show them off a little. You got to be ready. Yeah, he's waving to everyone in the room right now, and he's just smiling. He's such a happy, cute boy. I just, come on up here. He's still in the show. I want you to know that things are beginning to open up. My son Mark has a gift of evangelism. He is a pure evangelist with a prophet motive. It's just been glorious. Good morning, honey. There he is. Yes.
Want to say hi?
Show him off to everyone. Look how beautiful. Mark was just sharing with me yesterday that things are opening up in the spirit realm. He's going to be preaching revival meetings via tent outdoors. Yep. Yeah. Things are happening. Do you want to say good morning?
Sure. You want your grandson?
I do. I can hold that so I can hold the baby. Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. How are you? God bless you. What a wonderful day it is to be in the house of the Lord. And what's awesome, even if you're not in this building, God is with you right where you are. You are His temple. You are His tabernacle. The Holy Spirit lives inside of us. The same presence that's going to fall here this morning, I know, is going to fall upon you wherever you are. We're so blessed to be opening back up next Sunday on Father's Day. It is going to be an awesome day as we celebrate not just the fathers in the natural. It's going to be my first Father's Day, so I don't feel like a daddy, but I am a daddy, and it's, I mean, I feel like a daddy, I don't feel like a father. I don't know if that makes sense, but I want to celebrate John and my dad and fathers, but I get to be celebrated, which is cool. But more importantly, we get to celebrate our Heavenly Father together in person. And I want to encourage you, come out. The climate has changed. You can feel that the fear has lifted. The darkness feels like it's just lifted from the public. So it's time to get back together. It's time to have some church, if you know what I mean, in Jesus' name. It's time to get in His presence corporately. It's time to worship. It's time to release His glory. We're going to see a mighty move of His Spirit coming out of this pandemic, coming out of this storm. We're going to see a mighty wind of the Holy Spirit released into this region, into this house, into this territory, in Jesus' name. And if you can't join us, it is okay. There is no condemnation. When you are comfortable, come join us. There is no pressure whatsoever. We understand that some of you may still have underlying conditions or still may be doubtful of the climate. It's okay. Join us live. Join us. God has been moving through the live feeds just like He's going to do this morning. You can encounter Him from your home the same way you can encounter Him here. But we encourage you, if you feel comfortable, come out next Sunday. Let's get together. Let's have a glory celebration celebrating our Jesus. It's time. Revival. I'm going to say this real good and real clear. Revival is here. Now. It's now. Yeah. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Welcome, John and Melissa.
I got blessed by Benjamin. That makes me the happiest person on the face of the planet. It's a special blessing. Nothing quite like getting blessed by beautiful, beautiful little boy. Love him so much. Oh, my goodness. Welcome to Facebook Live. Woo! We're going to praise His name this morning. Wherever you're at, stand with us. And we're just going to praise Him and just celebrate Him, and we're going to get right in the presence of God right now. We thank You, Jesus, for who You are. Thank You, God, for being such a good Father. We invite You now into this place, Lord Jesus. We invite You in, Lord, to every single person's home right now, Lord Jesus, that's watching this, Lord God. We invite Your presence now in the name of Jesus. Thank You, God. Hallelujah. Free to clap along if you like.
I've got a river of living water, a fountain that never will run dry. It's an open heaven, and You're releasing, and we will never be denied. Cause we're stirring up deep, deep wells, stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance in the river, dance in the river. And we're stirring up deep, deep wells, we're stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna jump in the river, jump in the river. And deep cries out to deep cries out to you, we cry out to you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Never will run dry. Hallelujah. And it's an open heaven. And you're releasing. And we will never be denied. Oh, we're stirring up deep, deep wells. We're stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance in the river. Dance in the river. Stirring up deep, deep wells. Oh, stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna jump in the river. Jump in the river. Deep cries out to deep cries out to deep cries out to deep cries out to you. We cry out to you, Jesus. Oh, deep cries out to deep cries out to deep cries out to deep cries out to you. We cry out to you, Jesus. And it's rolling into deeper waters, calling out to you. We're walking into deeper.
In the spirit. Here we go.
And if he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna jump, 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 jump in the river. Jump, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. If he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna shout, shout in the river. Shout, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. If he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna dance, 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 dance in the river. Dance, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the right. If he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna shout, 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 shout in the river. Shout, 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 shout. Oh, deep cries out to deep cries out to deep cries out to deep cries out to. Deep cries out to, deep cry out to, we cry out to you, Jesus. We cry out to your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Lift up a shout of praise to the King of Kings. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good to me. You've turned my mourning into dancing. Put off all my rags, clothed me with gladness. And I will arise and I will praise you. I'll sing and not be silent. Oh, Lord. That the Lord is good. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good to me. You've turned my mourning into dancing. Put off my rags, clothed me with gladness. And I will arise, and I will praise you. I sing and not be silent. Oh Lord.
shouted to you, I will live only for you. I will lift these hands up to you. I will dance before you. I will shout it. I will shout it to you. Oh Lord, my God, I will give thanks to you forever. Oh Lord, my God, I will give thanks to you. Oh Lord, my God, I will give thanks to you forever. Oh Lord, my God, I will give thanks to you. I will live only for you. I will lift these hands up to you. I will dance before you. I will shout it. I will shout it to you. Oh Lord.
Shout of praise. We did this song before, but I want to do it again because I just feel like there's such power in this song, Champions. We're just going to do it one more time.
Tried so hard to see it. Took me so long to believe it. That you chose someone like me to carry your victory. Perfection could never earn it. You give what we don't deserve. Take the broken things and raise them to glory. And you are my champion. Giants fall when you stand undefeated. Every battle you've won. And I am who you say I am. You can round me. Seated in a heavenly place, undefeated with the one who has conquered it all. He's conquered it all. Now I can finally see it. You're teaching me how to receive it. So let all the striving see. This is my victory. Now I can finally see it. You're teaching me how to receive it. So let all the striving see. This is my victory. And you are my champion. When you stand undefeated.
voice. Come on. When I lift my voice and shout, everyone comes crashing down. I have the authority Jesus has given.
Champion, Lord, hallelujah. One more time, you're my champion.
Come on, lift your voice wherever you are right now. Lift your voice here in the sanctuary. Lift it at home right now. Because when we lift our voice and shout, walls come crashing down. When we open up our mouths, miracles start breaking out. You see, because we have been given the authority. You see, Jesus has given his authority unto us. It's time for the church to arise and shine. It's time for the church to open their mouth. It's time to slay some giants. It's time to see some walls come crashing down. It's time to see some miracles start breaking out. We're going to sing that again, bro. And we're going to bring it from here up. And we're going to see the Spirit of God released into your house, into this house, into the region. We're going to see some giants come down in Jesus' name. We're going to see the Spirit of God and miracles break out. Come on, lift your voices at home with us. Come on.
And shout, every wall comes crashing down. I have the authority that Jesus has given me. When I open up my mouth, miracles start breaking out. I have the authority that Jesus.
Jesus.
Hey.
Jesus, we give you praise this morning. You are our champion. You have conquered it all, Lord. We stand here in victory because you have made us victorious, not by our own actions, but because of your actions, Lord. We stand here undefeated. We stand here covered in your precious blood, declaring victory, declaring freedom, declaring healing to this nation. We declare that the church of Jesus Christ is raising up, not from a place of defeat, but a place of victory, God. We are not fighting towards victory, God. We are fighting from victory in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare the everlasting name. We declare the name that is above every name. We declare that Jesus Christ is Lord of this nation. We declare Jesus Christ is Lord of New Jersey. We declare Jesus Christ is Lord of Ocean County. We declare that Jesus Christ is Lord of Tom's River. He's the Lord of this house. He's the Lord of your house. And you stand undefeated right where you are right now because Jesus Christ has paid the price. You didn't earn it, but he gave it to us so we can walk it out, so we can declare and shout and open our mouths and see miracles break out. So lift your hands right now because we're going to sing one more song. We're going to raise a hallelujah in this place. And we want you to raise a hallelujah in your house. And we're going to believe that walls are just going to come crashing down. My God, I feel it. There's such a strong anointing up here right now on this. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare as we lift a hallelujah in this place, and as those watching, God, lift a hallelujah in their home where they are right now, that walls are going to start crashing down, God. That victory is going to be released in their hearts, in the atmosphere around them, God. We declare that the Spirit of God is ushering in a great move, God. We declare that the great harvest is upon us. We declare as we lift a hallelujah that the glory of God is going to fall like never before. So, Father, we are going to raise it up because you are who you say you are. You are the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And we will praise you and we will see your glory in the land of the living in Jesus' name. Lift your voice with us at home. Yeah.
And I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemy. Death is defeated. The King is alive.
Has made. We are rejoicing and we are glad in it. My God, my God, my God. Woo! There is glory in the house. There's such an anointing here. It's like Jesus is getting ready to open the doors of the sanctuary. Hallelujah. He is flooding the house with his glory. He is flooding the house. Woo! I pray in the name of Jesus, I just release that glory into every home that is listening right now. Wow. Lord, that you feel, oh, Father, every home, fill every home, Lord. Fill every home. You said that the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord. Lord, let it just cover every home, every household, in Jesus' name. Woo, Jesus. This is glorious. This is just glorious. There's the glory of God is in the house right now. Thank you, Lord. Well, if you are haven't already hit the share button, I'm going to ask you to share right now. The message I have is such a timely word. It is such a timely word for the body of Christ globally. In this hour, there are many voices that are out there right now, and there are many, many voices that are getting ready to rise up. You know, sometimes we think, oh, I can't take any more noise. We have to shut the news off. We have to shut out the clutter. We have to shut off even all the prophets sometimes. God forgive me. I'm not being sacrilegious there. But sometimes you just got to shut yourself away and hear for yourself. How are you going to have a confirmation if what they're saying is right? Unless you're hearing that word is supposed to bear witness with your spirit. Amen. So today I'm going to be bringing a very timely message on discerning of spirits. which is also the gift of discernment, the spiritual gift of discernment. And I want you to pay close attention. I have, yes, taught this as we've done the gifts of the Spirit, but today it's going to be a teaching, a preaching, an exhortation. Some of the prophetic will be coming out, the apostolic, because I want to make sure you're going to see all fivefold, because the pastor wants you to get this. The pastor is protecting the sheep, and today the message that I'm bringing is such an end time, last days message. We're preparing as the body of Christ. Hear this, for the greatest show on earth. We are getting ready for the greatest show on earth. We're going to see the church rise up in this hour. We're going to see revival and awakening in this nation and globally. This is going to be of a global magnitude. It will not be just a handful or a few churches or a few ministries. We are Christian Revival Center. We named this house for a reason. We want you to know who we are and what we represent. We are all about revival. We are all about seeing the saints of God awakened and brought back to the things of God, the truth of the Word of God. So we're about to see on this earth the greatest show in the church of awakening and revival. The saints are coming alive. The backsliders are coming home. Miracles, signs, and wonders are about to break out in an unprecedented scale. We're about to see souls saved like we've never seen before. It'll be like a cattle drive. It'll just be herds and herds of people flocking into the kingdom of God. And why is this going to be? Well, at the same time, the greatest show in the house of God, the world is going through a shaking. There is a shaking going on. There's two fires. You've heard me saying this. The fire of God that is in the church and the fire of God of judgment that's falling on the earth. But God is shaking everything that can be shaken so that those things that are of God will remain. Why do I tell you this every week? Because I want you to know what's going on and who is doing the shaking. We only get scared when we think the enemy is behind it or the government is behind it. No, the enemy can't take what you have because you belong to Jesus Christ. He's given it to you. You are receiving a kingdom, the Bible says in Hebrews 12, that cannot be shaken. We are of the unshakable ones. There's a t-shirt for us. We are the unshakable ones. Amen. Glory to God. So I'm going to open up by reading some scriptures. As a matter of fact, I would highly, highly encourage you today, if you're a note taker, to take notes. If you like to, which you should do, listen to the word over and over and over again. I know there's so much technology today. We have YouTube, we have Facebook, but we still use CDs also. We like to, or you know, whatever you like to pop in and listen to again and again and again. Let this word become a part of you. There's going to be a lot of scriptures today. Why is that? Because I'm teaching on discerning of spirits. The word of God is truth. Ooh. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So the battle, the warfare that we are in, and it is going to rage even more so as the days continue and go forth into the last of the last of the last days, the warfare is over truth. The warfare is over who is the way, the truth, and the life. You see, the world is preparing for an antichrist to rise up who wants to claim that he is God. But we know who is God. We know that Jesus Christ is God, and he holds all things together, what? By the power of his word. You must know the truth so the truth can set you free. Praise God. I would love some amens out there, some hallelujahs. You can high five me on Facebook. I'll be happy to see some. All right, so we're starting with Acts chapter 2. This is where Peter the apostle stood up on the day of Pentecost. It was not too long ago we celebrated Pentecost Sunday, and he quotes the prophet Joel. Now, in the Old Testament, Joel prophesied what God was going to be doing in the last days. So I want to start off here by giving you some signs of what the end of the age and the last days will look like so that you are aware of what to expect, what to be looking for, and that when these things begin to happen, that you're not shaken in your faith, but you will come up stronger and more confident because Jesus already told us these things were going to happen. So in Acts 2, starting with verse 16, it shall come to pass in the last days. That's where we are right now. God says that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. That is the great awakening and revival that we're talking about. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. Your old men shall dream dreams. And on my men servants and on my maid servants, I will pour out my spirit in those days. And they shall prophesy. Let's just pause right there a second. Who's doing the outpouring? God. Who's going to be pouring out his spirit? God. Who's it going to be poured out on? All flesh. Woo! Thank you, Lord. He said in those days. What days? The last days. What day are we in? The last days. So you should be expecting something to start happening if it hasn't already. But I want you to know, along with the shaking that the world is getting, that's going to intensify, so is the outpouring. We're just seeing the trickle of a tsunami. Hello? Be prepared. Woo, this is going to be a bridal wave. Hallelujah. He said, I'm going to pour out my spirit and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in heaven above and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the coming of the great and awesome day of the Lord. Sometimes when you read a different translation, that word awesome can be called dreadful. To the world, that day will be dreadful. To the church, it will be awesome. And it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. This is key to going forward, is calling on the name of the Lord. There will be many, many, many multitude, millions upon millions, probably, hopefully up into the billions, who will be calling on the name of the Lord for salvation in the days ahead. Woo! Can you feel that? I hope you can feel that. Don't ever get tired of hearing some scriptures you've heard before again. Jesus said, again, I say to you, we must build our faith in this. Faith comes by hearing the word. You need your faith built to the point of expectation that we are expecting these things to come, these things to happen. Now in the New Testament, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 24, the disciples started asking Jesus, what will be the signs of your coming? What will be the signs of the last days? And to prepare the disciples, he started to teach them. Not only did he teach them, but he began to warn them. He gave them warnings. Now, we are disciples of Jesus Christ, if Jesus is your Lord and Savior. So you can take that as Jesus is sitting down with you and saying, Al and Ken and John and Monica, I want to prepare you for the days that are coming. I want to prepare you for what will be happening. God says, I don't want you to be afraid. I want you to look up because your redemption is getting closer than it ever was before. In Matthew 24, starting with verse 3, now as he came on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, that's Jesus, saying, tell us, when will these things be? Now, if you go on into the book of Acts, the first chapter, Jesus says to them, it's not for you to know the times and the seasons. Only the Father knows those things. But they started asking him, when is all this going to happen? And a lot of us, you know, might be asking, and listen, don't buy into, we're talking about discerning of spirits today, if someone starts giving you a date, Hello? Oh, that's like 101 discernment. That's like baby steps, right? That's like Jesus said, nobody will know except the Father. So if someone starts giving you a date, they're a false prophet. All right? Or they're prophesying in a spirit of error. This is where discernment comes in. All right. He says, tell us when these things will be and what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age. Now, that's something Jesus has given us the answer for. Jesus answered and said to them, take heed that no one deceives you. This is huge. The first thing Jesus says to them when they say, what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age is, number one, take heed means watch out. Be careful. Have your eyes open that no one deceives you. This is key. This is huge. Jesus is telling them that there is a deception. Woo! That is going to be coming on the earth in the last days. But you, as my disciples, make sure that you do not get deceived. For many will come in my name, saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See to it that you are not troubled or afraid, you could say. For all these things must come to pass. Hear this, but the end is not yet. My God, I think of World War I, World War II, the different wars that this world, this globe has been through. I was reading about another time in history where there was huge plagues and people actually thought this was the last days, the end of all time. Jesus said, you're going to see these things. There will be wars. There will be rumors of wars. He said, but the end is not yet. See, we haven't seen the end yet. He said, the nations will rise against nations and kingdoms against kingdoms. There is a clashing right now on the news every day. There is a separating going on of nations as to who will be the sheep nations, those that will go with the Lord, and those that will be goat nations that will rise up and go along with the Antichrist spirit. These are signs of the times. This is what is happening right now. Nation is rising up against nation, but also kingdom is rising up against kingdom. We have to be aware of these things as kingdom residents, what's going on, and who is doing this? God is doing this. He said that there will be famines and pestilence. Pestilence, another word, is plagues, diseases. We've been experiencing this, and earthquakes in various places. Now listen to this next sentence. All these are the beginning of sorrows. Did you hear that? He said the end is not yet, and this is just the beginning of sorrows. So what he's telling us here is that when we see these things happening, know that you are at the beginning of the ending. Wow. I can safely say that and not be called a false prophet. Hallelujah. Turn on the news. Read the headlines. You'll see that this is where we are. He said, then, after this, they will deliver you up to tribulation and kill you. Judy, give us some good news. All right, it's coming. And they will be hated, he says, by all nations for my name's sake. In America, we're just beginning to see some persecution. We do not have persecution as other nations have it as of yet. But when you see the persecution arising, especially on the church and on the believers, then know that things are coming to an end. He said, many false prophets. Can I repeat that word? Many. Many. He didn't say a couple, a handful, a few. Jesus, talking to his disciples, said many false prophets will rise up and do what? Deceive many. Oh my goodness. You can look back at the Jim Jones and some of the crazy stuff that has come just in this past century that has come to deceive many people to the point where they were all drinking poisoned Kool-Aid. You know, that's where the term drinking, they drank the Kool-Aid comes from, you know. But this is not even, this isn't such an obvious deception, which is why I'm taking this week, and I will also be doing part two the week after Father's Day, on the signs of the end times and how much we need the gift of discerning of spirits and discernment operating in our lives. He said, and because lawlessness will abound. Another translation says lawlessness will increase. What we have experienced and seen on the news as a nation and globally over the past several weeks has been lawlessness rising to a new level. When you see a police officer murdering a black man, and when you see riots and people breaking and destroying personal property of individuals and their businesses, this is crossing the line into lawlessness. So we must realize the time we're living in. He said that lawlessness will abound and the love of many will grow cold. How can you put your hand or knee on someone's neck that's shouting, I can't breathe, and you not have a heart? This is a sign of hearts growing cold and lawlessness abounding. Now, Jesus already said these things would happen. Do we like them? No, we hate them. But we must know the truth and stand for truth. I'm going to say this a lot in this teaching. The war that we are in and the war we're going into in the days ahead will be over truth. You must know that, because if there's deception coming, deception is founded on lies. Jesus said, you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Politics, universities, media, social media, the news media have been plagued with false philosophies, lies, and deceptions. And it's intensifying and getting worse. We must know what truth is to counteract and guard and shield our minds and our spirits from deception. Wow. Judy, you're right there today. I'm going further. I cannot do this all in one week because this is such a thorough teaching. This is such a much needed teaching and a very strong teaching. I've been praying all morning and last night that this will go forth strong, that my voice will be strong, that the authority of heaven will back up every word, because you must hear this. As the church, as believers, share this, get this word out, because truth will counteract the deception just like light expels darkness. Woo, do you hear that? All right, now some good news. But I love when but is in scripture. But he who endures to the end shall be saved. There's an endurance that we must tap into in these last days. Endurance is the ability to bounce back no matter what hell and the devil and life and this world throws at you. He said, he who endures to the end shall be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom, there you go, will be preached in all the world. That is what is trying to be stopped right now, is the gospel of the kingdom of God, which is the truth, going into every nation of the world, and it will be a witness to all nations, the Bible says. You will not be able to say, I didn't know the truth. Because the gospel is the witness of the truth. And then he says, and then the end will come. My God. Sounds like a lot's going to happen first, doesn't it? It doesn't sound like we're there yet. It sounds like a lot's going to happen before the end. So if you have one of those right now mentalities, I'm out of here. Well, you're not ready yet. The church isn't ready yet. The gospel hasn't been preached in every nation yet. The end has not come. Jesus said it's just the beginning of sorrows and the gospel being preached in every nation. One more foundational scripture, and then we're going right into the meat of the teaching. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1. Now, here we first, I had Peter quoting the prophet Joel from the book of Acts on the day of Pentecost. Then I went to Jesus in the Gospel of Matthew, training his disciples. Judy, what's the foundation of everything you're telling me? The Word of God. Now, we're to take the balance, the whole Word of God. Now we have the Apostle Paul in the New Testament, and he is warning and preparing his spiritual son, Timothy, who was a pastor under him, and he was preparing him how to stand in the last days. And he said right here, now the Spirit, ooh, that's the Holy Spirit. That's the Spirit of God, the Spirit of truth. Paul tells Timothy, now the Spirit expressly says that in the latter times or in the last days, some will depart from the faith. Why am I teaching this? Because I don't want to see anyone fall away. The Bible warns of a great falling away before the day of the coming of the Lord. He said that some will depart from the faith, giving heed to what? Deceiving spirits. What is going to cause the falling away in the last days? Deceiving spirits. He said, and doctrines of demons. This is heavy stuff. You're not used to this on a Sunday morning, are you? Judy, we don't want this on a Sunday morning. Well, you know why I'm bringing this on a Sunday morning? Number one, I ask God what he wants me to talk about. I ask God what is needed most right now. And I'm bringing it on a Sunday morning because we get the largest audience on a Sunday morning. I want this message to go global. I don't want any of you to fall away. Amen? We do not want to be ignorant of the enemy's schemes. We don't want to be deceived. We don't want anyone to fall away. So this will be a culmination of a lot of things this morning. You're going to see me going from one gifting to another, to another, to another. I am an apostle. That is my commissioned title. That is the office that I operate in. I'm coming you today as a teacher. I am coming as a pastor because I want to guard the sheep. I'm coming to you as a prophet, bringing a prophetic word, a now word, a timed word. This is not an ego thing. I'm just giving you the authority of heaven that's on me, that's backing this up. I don't need to validate myself. I know who I am. Hallelujah. But for those who don't know who I am, discerning of spirits is one of the gifts I operate very strongly in. As a matter of fact, if you operate in that gift, I know certain people just come to my mind that I know operate in that gift. People tend to stay away from you. They don't want to get too close because they know you can see. And you're seeing into them, and you're seeing what's behind what's being said. You're seeing the motive or the spirit behind what is being said or portrayed. So people get a little nervous around that. I've gotten in a lot of trouble in a lot of churches because of this gift, because this gift will expose things. Ah, but Jesus said in this hour, we need to come up higher. In this gift, we need to learn to discern the spirits now more than ever. The Antichrist spirit, the one world government spirit, all these things are trying to rise up right now. The false prophet, that spirit is already in the world and it's already, oh, it's on media, Turn it off. Don't fill your spirit with lies. Fill your spirit with truth. It's like you've heard this taught a million times, but how do you train people to recognize counterfeit dollar bills? They don't study counterfeits. They study the real thing. And when a counterfeit comes along, they see it. They recognize it. They know it because they've studied the real deal. You study the Word of God, and when a counterfeit comes along, you will know it. Your spirit will recognize that. Ooh, I got chills on that one. Yes, that hit you right at home. I felt that. Woo! Now, the three scriptures that I opened up with, all three of them are addressing what will be happening in the last days. They're addressing the days that we are living in and the days that we are going more and more into in the days ahead. Those scriptures I read to you are filled with warnings, and they're filled with preparations, and they're also filled with what to watch for and what to expect. You must pay attention when Jesus says something like that. And the number one thing that Jesus said to his disciples is, see to it that no one deceives you. He didn't say, I'm going to see to it for you. Hear that. He said, you see to it. Another translation says, take heed. That means pay attention. Make sure this doesn't happen to you, that no one will deceive you. Why? The Apostle Paul told Timothy, there will be many deceiving spirits and doctrines of devils that are going to be multiplying in the last days, causing some to depart from the faith and to fall away. But whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The Bible in the book of Revelation always and over and over and over, to him who overcomes, to him who overcomes, to him who overcomes. You need a spirit of endurance and an overcomer spirit in this hour. Woo, my goodness. Hebrews chapter 12, starting with verse 25, says that God is beginning to shake all things. It says that right now, even in the book of Haggai, the same thing. He's the prophet of shaking. We are in a time of shaking. Things are being shaken. What God is trying to shake off and expose is the lies. He's trying to shake off and expose the deception. You know, I preached a message about 3 weeks ago. If you didn't listen to it, I pray that you do, called the Deep State Church. Because the Deep State Church is what's going to counteract the Deep State government. We must rise up with our voices, and we must pray and speak the truth to counteract the lies and deception of this hour. In verse 25 of Hebrews 12, it says, see that you do not refuse him who speaks. Wow. What do we see happening every single day? We see people refusing him who's speaking. They're turning their backs on God. They're denying the reality of God. You see, he said, don't refuse him who speaks. The Bible says that what is doing the shaking is his voice. My God. He said, my voice will shake the earth. My voice, my spoken word, my truth will shake the earth. And everything that is not founded and rooted and grounded in the truth will be shaken, and only what is of God will remain. Woo! Make sure you hang on to the truth. Wow. Oh my goodness. Wow. There's so much glory up here. Woo! That just hit me big. I just take some, everybody. Pray it goes right over the airwaves. Wow. Now, discernment or discerning of spirits, I'm going to hit both of them, so they're going to kind of weave together. They are, or it is, one of the most vital and important end time gifting. Discerning of spirits, the spiritual gift of discernment, and it is unfortunately one of the most neglected gifts. Whoo! hear that? It is one of the most neglected, but the most needed, especially for this hour. Now, I like to joke about it because if you go to a group setting with a bunch of Christians, and, you know, we always like to go to where it's happening down the road, of course, in quarantine. Now we're going on Facebook. Who's happening on Facebook, you know? But we all want to follow the prophets. We all want to hear the word of the Lord. We want to get a word from the Lord. We want to hear the now word. We want to hear the message. If we know that someone's preaching and they've got the gift of healing or miracles, we're going to flock there because we want to see the signs and we want to see the wonders. Listen, there are 9 spiritual gifts. There are 9 spiritual gifts that God has given the body of Christ. The 3 gifts are the voice of God. The first 3 is prophecy and it's tongues and interpretation of tongues. Those are the voice of God. Many times in a service, you're going to hear tongues and interpretation of tongues. Not a lot of that lately. We need to resurrect that gift. But it's the voice of God speaking to his people. Prophecy. People flock to prophecy. Then you have the power of God gifts. Remember, there's 9. The first 3 are the voice of God. The 3 power gifts are healings, miracles, and the gift of faith, because they operate by faith. So you've got the power of God gifts. But now the last 3, that was 6 of them, but the last 3, and here's what you need to know in this hour more than ever, is the mind of God. We did the power of God, the voice of God, but the body of Christ, I don't know how else to say this, has neglected the mind of God. They're not listening to God's thoughts. They're listening to what the prophets are saying. But the prophets, if they're true prophets, should be saying God's thoughts. They're the voice of God that should verbalize God's thoughts. Now, in those 3 gifts, you have word of wisdom. Don't know what to do in a situation, you need God's wisdom. Word of knowledge is what to do with that wisdom, what to do in that situation. But the last one that we're going to be focusing on is discerning of spirits. Amen. That is the mind of God. We cannot ignore this gift. But listen, I don't hear anybody saying, you got to go to this church, man, because this preacher, they really operate in discerning of spirits. They will read your mail. They'll see right through you. They'll know what motive is behind you. They'll know what's behind what's being said. We all go, we don't want that gift. We don't want to be around that gift. That's where we need to be. You better make sure your spirit's clean. You better make sure your spirit and heart and motives are pure. Why? Because the Bible says you can't take the speck out of someone else's eye. Hello? Until you take the speck out of your own, you got to make sure your heart is clean, your heart is pure, your motives are pure, so you can rightly discern others. Ooh, Judy, I am so meddling. Doesn't it feel good? Hey, if you can't say amen, say ouch, but it's a good ouch. It's a feel-good ouch. Woo! All right, we're going to go like rapid fire through some scriptures now, so buckle your seatbelt. Proverbs 16:2 says, all a man's ways, not some of them, all of a man's ways seem innocent to him. Aww. I'm just so bright, I'm just so pure, I'm just right, hello? But motives are weighed by the Lord. Woo! Where'd that scripture? Is that really in the Bible? Yeah, it is. That's one of those ones you flipped over. It's one of those ones that you didn't want to read. Woo! All a man's ways seem innocent to him, but motives are weighed by the Lord. That word motives in Hebrews is spirits. Woo! That is what makes up your moral character and disposition. And if something in your spirit isn't right, something in your motives won't be right. Oh my goodness, do you think God's calling us to a higher place of accountability? Do you think God's calling us to a new level of integrity in this hour because of the deceiving spirits that are about to be unleashed? Oh boy, the New King James Version puts it this way, all the ways of a man are pure in his own eyes. I didn't do it. Ask your kids. It starts when they're little. It's called the sinful nature. We didn't do it. I'm innocent, right? All the ways of a man are pure in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs the spirits. Wow. You see, spirits are discerned. That's why it's called the gift of discerning of spirits. Now, when I tell you about this gift, right away you start thinking of like Ghostbusters, like discerning of spirits, like, you know, you think demons and you think all bad stuff, but we're talking here about motives. We're talking about the ways of a man and what's in his spirit. You see, discerning of spirits is not just, oh, I discern a spirit of Antichrist in the world. Well, hello, rocket scientist. Spirit 101 basics. We need to come down here where we live and discern our own spirit and discern the spirits of those around us. Because another scripture, didn't Jesus say, many will come in my name and say, Lord, Lord, didn't I do this in your name? And didn't I prophesy in your name? Didn't I cast out devils in your name? And what's Jesus' answer to them? Get away from me. I never knew you. Whoa. Wow. These, I'm bringing right now to you scriptures that you don't like. What am I doing? I'm not giving you dessert. I'm giving you your vitamins. I'm giving you your protein mix. I'm giving you your veggies. I'm giving you what you will need in this hour to endure and succeed. Woo, Judy. Yeah, we're going somewhere today. Wow. Spirits are discerned. It's discerning of spirits. The Lord weighs the heart. He sees the heart, and he weighs the spirit. Proverbs 16:21, the wise in heart are called discerning. Wow. But the man of understanding walks uprightly. You know who's going to love this message? Your dad. Yes, he will love it because he's a teacher and he loves the truth and he loves the word. For all you teachers out there, you will appreciate this. For those that don't, take your medicine. All right. Eat your vitamins, eat your veggies. Amen. Folly is joy. Oh boy, is joy to him who is destitute of discernment. We don't use the word folly much in today's language, but it's foolishness. Foolishness becomes a joy to those that are destitute of discernment. They have no discernment. But a man of understanding walks uprightly. Proverbs 2:10-12. When wisdom enters your heart. Ooh, because what did I just say? That it's wisdom. It's wisdom. The wise in heart are called discerning. When wisdom enters your heart, the knowledge and knowledge is pleasant to your soul. Discretion or discernment will preserve you. Understanding will keep you to deliver you from the way of evil, from the man who speaks perverse things. What I'm teaching you right now says that it will preserve you, it will keep you, and it will deliver you from things that are being spoken that are evil and perverse. Now, we're living in an evil and perverse generation, amen? An evil and perverse time. We need this gift. I would love it, love it, love it, love it. If maybe 10 months from now, when we're all open in full force and getting into a bigger building, if people would say, you gotta go to CRC. There is so much discerning of spirits there. Man, the spirit of discernment is just flowing in that church. That is a compliment that you don't hear. Because what it says is they know the spirit of truth, and a stranger's voice they won't hear. Ooh. Hello, Judy. She's preaching today. Ah, all right. Proverbs 2, 1 through 9 says, if you receive my words, treasure my commands within you, incline your ear to wisdom, apply your heart to understanding. Yes, listen to this. If you cry out for discernment and lift your voice for understanding, seek her as silver, search for her as for hidden treasures, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. This right here, the Bible says there is something that we are told by the Spirit of God, by God Almighty, that we are to cry out for. Wow. Cry out for discernment. Cry out for it. Why? Because without Christ, without the Spirit of the living God, we are foolish. We tend to go toward the things we shouldn't go toward, which is Romans chapter 7. The Apostle Paul says, why do I keep doing the things I don't want to do? But then he goes on into 8 and he says, those that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the mature sons of God. We must know these things in the days ahead. My God, we are to cry out for discernment as though it was a hidden treasure, the Bible says. Why? Because it'll keep us. It'll preserve us. It'll deliver us. Wow. Sounds like there's an enemy out there that wants to do some destruction. Amen. Proverbs 4:7, wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and in all your getting, get understanding. She will preserve you. She will keep you. She will promote you. My gosh, I've seen a lot of self-promoting people lately, a lot of self-promotion. God is the one that promotes you. When you walk in wisdom, when you cry out for discernment, the Bible says that this is what will promote you. When I see someone that I know is in tune with the Spirit of God, when I see someone that comes into the congregation that has a strong spirit of right and wrong and truth and error, I keep my eye on them. Because God says, I'm going to promote that person. They love my word. They have cried out for discernment. Woo! Why are leaders getting deceived? Why are leaders falling away? Maybe they need to cry out. Drop the mic. Let that one go right there. I'm not going to pursue that because that's not my message. But Selah. Hallelujah. You see, the church has been stumbling and the world has been laughing. Amen. They don't respect us and they don't want to be like us. We've brought reproach to Jesus' name. I'm talking about the church overall. I'm talking about fallen leaders. I'm talking about Christians that do drugs and sleep around and say, I'm saved. Oh, boy. How many times I've heard of someone getting into trouble. I've heard of someone falling. I've heard of someone getting deceived. And my first thing is, where was the discernment? Where was the discernment? The church should be so strong in that gift now more than ever. You have an election coming up. We have presidential elections. We have local governmental elections. You don't know these people. You're not in their house living with them. You need discernment. You need a discerning of spirits to discern truth from error, right from wrong. Discern the motives of the heart of who's speaking. We must rise up in discernment. Woo. It is scarce in the body of Christ. It is neglected in the body of Christ, and it is the most needed gift in the body of Christ in this hour. Wow. As you can tell, there is no way I'm going to get through all of this today. But we are going to delve into this gift. I want you to become so sharp in the spirit. Whew. I'm telling you what, I haven't felt an anointing like this on preaching anything since quarantine as I'm feeling now. Because out of the ashes, hope will arise. God is going to say, let me teach you some things. Let me instruct you in some things so this doesn't happen again. Or when it does, you will know what's going on, what's behind it, who's behind it, what spirit's behind it, what motives are behind it. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Woo. Psalm 119, verse 130 says, the entrance of your words gives light. It gives understanding to the simple. The entrance of Jesus' words gives light. What does that mean? It means when his words enter my spirit, they bring with them the light of the word of God, which is the truth. They bring revelation. They bring understanding. They bring wisdom with them. And it enters your spirit and begins to renew your mind. Your thinking begins to change when the word of God enters your spirit. Wow. This is what we're going to be seeing in the days ahead when we go into revival. An awakening. We're going to literally see with our physical eyes the word of God taking root in someone's spirit and watching the light of truth come on. Watching that spirit of revelation and salvation being birthed in their spirit man. See, you were spiritually dead till his word entered your spirit. When the word, hey, listen, it wasn't because somebody laid hands on you that you got saved. It wasn't because you got to know this. It wasn't because you felt Holy Ghost goosebumps that you got saved. You got saved, born again, when the word of truth entered your spirit and you received it. When your spirit agreed with that spirit of God, of truth. Up until then, you didn't know the truth. Up until then, you walked in darkness. But when the entrance of the word came, it brought light. It brought revelation. It brought salvation. God's word is a discerner. I'm talking about the gift of discernment and discerning of spirits. This is all an introduction. Believe me, this is just the foundation, all right? God's word is the discerner. You better hear that. The Bible says about itself that it separates soul and spirit. It's a divider. It divides. It separates soul and spirit. It separates what you think from what God says. If what you think or what you feel doesn't align with what God's word says, the truth, the Bible says that the word of God is a two-edged sword and it separates and divides. Truth, error. My thoughts, God's thoughts. Satan's lies, God's truth. Rightly divide and discern truth from error. This is where we're going and what we must know in the days ahead. Why? I already read it to you. There will be many deceiving, which means lying, spirits. They're already out there. Now, the word of God is a discerner. It is time for us to become discerners of what? Thoughts. Thoughts. Who or what is controlling their thinking. It's a discerner of thoughts. That's why people run away from people with discerning of spirits. Woo! Because it goes beyond what's being said. It discerns from the Spirit of God what's behind what's being said. It discerns thoughts. Who is saying those thoughts? who is controlling their thinking, hello, not only their thoughts, but their motives. Ooh, why are they saying what they're saying? Why are they allowing themselves to think that way and believe that way? Now, I just read to you earlier that God is the one who weighs the heart, the motives, the spirit, or discerns them. You see, what we're seeing on the surface, you've got different levels and different realms. What's going on in your spirit? What's going on in your thoughts? What's going on in your mind and emotions is a level we can't see with these eyes. Because the spirit is discerned with the spirit. We must become a people that discern with the spirit from God's spirit. What are the motives behind what they are saying and what they really mean, or what they really don't want us to know? Ooh, I know your mind's going in 100 directions. Somebody that's lying to you, the politicians, the media, what's going on? I would say for the past 3 months, this nation has been crying out for truth. What's really going on? I'll leave it at that. The Word of God is a discerner of thoughts, of motives, what is pushing that person, what is driving that person. You see, Jesus leads, Satan drives or pushes. Is it God leading or is it Satan pushing? What is the motive? What is the thought pattern? What are the intentions? What is it they really want to do? What is it they really want? What is it that, or who? Who do they want to control? What do they want to control? What's really going on within or behind the scenes? Another thing the Word of God is a discerner of is hidden agendas. Ooh, I am so meddling today. I hope to God that the church becomes the number one discerner of this globe, that we will be the ones that know the truth and can set others free by it. What are the hidden agendas behind what is being said? You see, Satan can say one thing. Didn't God say, you can eat this fruit, Eve? You're not going to die. God didn't really say that, did he? That hasn't changed in all these thousands and thousands and thousands of years. Did God really say? That's how he starts, putting doubt in the character of God. But what's the hidden agenda behind that? To cause you to stumble, to cause you to fall, to cause you to fall away, to cause you to doubt. My God, to doubt God, to doubt his goodness, to stop trusting him. Not only is the Word of God a discerner of thoughts, intents, motives, hidden agendas. This is just an intro. We're going to go into all of this deeper. But the spirit behind what is being said or done, not just said, but done, the spirit that is influencing what is being said or done, the spirit that is controlling the person or the words that are coming across. Now listen, we don't have to just be talking about a person here. We can be talking about corporations, nations, leaders, politicians. Ooh, what is the spirit that is influencing, controlling? Here's another one, or oppressing or depressing that person. I pray for President Trump. Not one time in my life have I ever sat down and said, "Hi, President Trump. What can I pray for you about today?" Why? Because I don't know him. But I will watch his face. I'll watch his eyes. I'll watch his expressions. And I will ask the Spirit of God to discern what he needs, what's really going on. When I hear the news media and I hear a reporter, I don't know that person. I wasn't there when those things happened. But I will ask the Spirit of the Lord, rightly divide this. Separate truth from error. Cause me to discern what spirits are speaking right now. You'll watch. My husband will hear me on the other end of the house binding someone in the name of Jesus who's lying on the television set. They're reporting fake news, lies, lying spirits, and I'll go, "I bind that lying spirit in Jesus' name." You have the authority. We must use the authority, but to use the authority, you must discern what is behind, what is really going on. Ooh, my goodness, my goodness. Listen, what influence is that person under? What influence? How are you going to set them free? Listen, many times people come up to this altar for prayer. If I didn't operate in a gift of discerning of spirits, I would be here all day praying for you and not getting anything done. Do you understand? If you're an intercessor, more than ever, you need this gift. If you're a leader, more than ever. If you're a worship leader, more than ever, you got to discern the spiritual atmosphere of a room. You've got to discern when a person comes up to me. Are they listening to the enemy? Is this their own thoughts? Are these familiar spirits? What's a familiar spirit? It's a lie, or just all the enemy has to do is just say one little thing that wounded you back in your childhood, or an ex-spouse or a mother or a father, or someone said something, something happened, and it left an open wound, a sore spot. And the enemy doesn't have to beat you up all day. You'll take care of that. All they have to do is go, "Did they really mean that?" And you go, oh, my God, did they really mean that? What were they really meaning? Oh, gosh, I feel so much, I'm so hurt. Oh, I feel so much rejection. Oh, Lord, oh, I come up to the altar. By the time I get here, I am depressed, oppressed, lied to, bound up in the spirit, tied in knots, don't even know who I am in Christ anymore. Do you understand? When that person stands in front of me, I don't coddle them. I address the spirit that's attacking their mind. I bind that lying spirit. I break its power off of them. I cancel the assignment. I go back to those word curses that were spoken in their spirit, and I call them null and void. I cancel them and make them ineffective. Then I can pray for God to heal their mind, restore them, comfort them, and cause their spirit man to rise up again, strong in who they are in Christ. Don't tell me the church doesn't need this gift. Ooh, someone can come up to me. Got an intercessor here this morning, and they'll say to me, "I got a backache." I'm like, Spirit of God goes, "They hate their mother." Well, I could pray for your back all day. I'll waste both our time. You understand? I pray for them, and I say, "Is there any unforgiveness in your life? Is there someone you're holding a grudge?" Now, remember the opening scripture that a man's ways are all pure to himself? Oh, no, I forgive everybody. Oh, no, not me. I love everybody. I'm not angry. Nobody. Holy Spirit just said your mother. Oh, oh, and they just start falling apart. I don't need to counsel them for 10 hours. I need one word of knowledge. One word of knowledge. Discerning of spirits. Boom! Get to the root. Yank it out. Cut it off. Back pain's gone. Just like that. Just like that. How great is our God? How awesome is our God? Woo, Jesus. My God, I don't even know where to go from here. I've got so much. Wow. Hebrews 4:13 says, the word of God is living and powerful. Do you see this as alive? This is alive. You know, the word of God is creative. God spoke, let there be, and there was. I just read you Hebrews 4:13. For the word of God is living and powerful. Another translation says active. Sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division or dividing of soul and spirit and joints and marrow. Then it goes on to say it is a discerner of thoughts and intents or motives of the heart. And that word motives means spirits. What spirits are operating in a person's heart? Wow. Wow. The word of God is the spirit of truth. And that truth, I just read to you in one scripture, Hebrews 4:13, it is living, it is alive, it is powerful. God's word has the power within itself to bring itself to pass. It is sharp like a sword because it cuts right to the truth, right to the core. It divides truth from error. You know, there's a lot of good people that operate in a spirit of error. I could get really deep with you right now. I'm going to try to keep it simple. But a spirit of error must be discerned. Someone is believing, they love Jesus, they hear from God, but familiar spirits have a way into their spirit because they have a wounded spirit. This is all spirit, heart, right? They have some unresolved issues. And so if it's a spirit of rejection or whatever it is they're carrying, but it says that the word of God will separate and divide what is the truth and what is something that's a spirit of error in them, means that they are believing something that's not truth based on their wounding. They believe things that are based on their wounding. Oh, to take this on a huge, large scale, women's lib. Listen, I'm a woman who heads up a ministry. I'm an apostle. I believe in women's rights. I don't believe in rebellion and deception. There's a lot of women that are taking authority and taking position because they're angry. Their spirit isn't right because these women, I guarantee you, if I sit down with them and counsel with them and get into their kitchen, they were wounded by some male in their life, some male authority, a father, an uncle, a neighbor. Somebody abused them. Somebody molested them. Somebody raped them. And that rage is now women's rights. Get them healed, and they'll be strong women for the right reason. Ooh. Do you understand now? Yes, equality, error because of wrong motives, because of wounds. We've got to rightly divide and discern. The Bible is the dividing factor that divides thoughts and intentions. What's going on in your heart and your mind and your spirit? Your spirit is where God lives. That's where the word of God is. That's where the truth lies. Now, the truth isn't always in your mind and your emotions. Understand that. So we've got to be a discerner so that we can rightly divide what's of God, what's of the enemy, what's my own thoughts. What comes out of the past and the wounding? A lot of people bring their past into their Christianity with them. I see it all the time. We knew of someone that was in witchcraft in their life before they became a Christian. And now, as a Christian, they love Jesus, but they want to control and manipulate everything. Because those are familiar spirits. And they've brought the witchcraft into their Christianity, and they don't understand what spirit they're operating in their Christianity. Ooh, how much do we need this gift? My God. I said to you, the constant battle will be for the truth. You'll know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Now, I just mentioned witchcraft. I've seen people bring their religion into their Christianity. One of the things we bind and break off more than anything is a spirit of religion. Because religion gives you rules, regulations, regiment. I have to earn my way to God. I have to be good enough for God. Hello? And you bring that spirit into your Christianity, then you walk through the doors of the sanctuary with that spirit of religion that you carried into your Christianity into corporate worship. I'm tired. Let's become discerning. Let's let the Word of God set us free from these things. Ooh, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness. I'll give you a little discerning of spirits humor. Someone asked Chuck Pierce, who we all know is a respected international prophet and apostle, do you see a demon behind every rock? He said, no, I see 12. If they're yours. If they're mine, I get rid of them. That's where you need to be. I discern yours, but I get rid of mine. Ah, I might have to stop right there. I just might have to stop right there. This is where we need to be, church. We need to be seeing what other people are carrying so we can pray effectively. Let the Word of God rightly divide and discern and separate and set people free so that they can rightly discern and not become deceived themselves. We must become discerning. Ooh, my goodness. 1 Corinthians 12, I'm going to be ending right with this little section here, and I'll pick up where we left off. Not next week, because it's Father's Day, and we're going to be celebrating, but after that, I'm going right back into this. 1 Corinthians 12, starting with verse 1. The Apostle Paul says, now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I do not want you ignorant. How many of you can truly tell me you're fluent in discerning of spirits? The word ignorant could mean unskilled, lacking knowledge, untrained, immature, naive. When it comes to discerning of spirits, brethren, I don't want you untrained, unskilled, ignorant, and naive. Wow. You know, we all want to prophecy. I could pack this room out. I'm teaching on how to prophesy, how to give a word, how to get a word. I'll pack the house. Woo! Yes, I could tell you I'm going to be teaching on miracles tonight. Oh, my goodness, they'll be lined up out the door, waiting to get in here for that teaching. Woo! When I say to you, I'm teaching on discerning of spirits. Where'd everybody go, John? Where's the line? Where's the line? But yet, this gift, that is one of the most neglected gifts, is the most needed gift, especially in this hour, in these last days. And the Apostle Paul told the church of Corinth, why? Because they were a gifted church that was out of control. They were bouncing off the walls, swinging on the chandeliers, rolling down the aisles, and they didn't know anything about how the gifts operated. and he had to bring order and instruction to this church on how to operate in the gifts. And he said, concerning spiritual gifts, Corinthian church, I don't want you ignorant. Because why? It makes the church a target for the enemy, look foolish to the world. Ignorant means uneducated, unlearned, untrained, lacking knowledge, being gullible. It leads to being gullible. There's a lot of gullible sheep out there that are believing whatever they're being told. Why does God want me to bring this message now? So that you are not ignorant and gullible and undiscerning. This is where we're going to close. John chapter 10. Oh, listen to this. I hope you're still with me. I don't care if the sun is shining. I'm tired of God competing with the weather. Ooh, things can wait, but God can't. John chapter 10, starting with verse 2. He who enters the door by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the doorkeeper opens, and the sheep hear his voice. And he calls his own sheep by name, and he leads them out. Out of what? Out of deception, out of your past, out of all the sin, out of the error. He leads them out. He calls his own sheep by name, and he leads them out. And when he brings them out, his own sheep, he goes before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. Yet they will by no means follow a stranger, but will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of strangers. Wow. He said, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger's voice they will not listen to. He said, when I have a sheep, he says, I call them out by name. He calls them out by name. They recognize the name. They recognize the voice. And it says that he leads them out. There's a lot of stuff Jesus wants to lead you out of. There's a lot of lies, a lot of falsehoods, a lot of woundings, a lot of wrong influence, a lot of sin, a lot of deception. Well, I can be a Christian and still do this. Hello? I can still be this. I can still do that. God loves everybody. That is truth taken out of context. He loves everybody. He said, love the sinner, hate the sin. He separated. There it is, rightly dividing, separating truth from error. Yes, the truth is God loves everybody, but the error is it's okay to do anything and be everybody and live the life you want to live. That's not in agreement with what he has for you. That's the deception. Wow. What we're going to see in the days and months ahead is a lot of people being led out of deception. For people to be led out of deception, we're talking about coming into a great awakening. The entrance of your word gives light. They're going to start seeing the truth. But how many of you know that the day you got saved, you didn't understand everything? There were layers and layers and layers, because God can't give it to you all. It's like peeling an onion. It's a layer at a time till he gets to the core, to the root of the heart and the motives and the intentions and the things that have been controlling you your whole life that you had no idea were controlling you. That's another drop mic. See, we want to be those that can bring the lost the healing that they need. We want to be the ones that can discern what's really going on in someone's heart so that we can pray correctly and set them free. To do that, we must be the ones who have the gift of discernment in full operation. You're not going to operate in the gift of miracles, in the gift of healing, in the gift of prophecy, correctly hearing a word of wisdom, hearing a word of knowledge, if you are not walking in discerning of spirits. Because you will not be able to rightly discern what's really going on. I love you. You still love me? Amen. Let's stand. We're going to close. Ooh, my gosh. We just went to church. We just went to church. Ooh. Like I said, sometimes you got to eat your veggies. This is like an energy drink. This is like your protein. This is what's going to build your spiritual muscles. I don't want to stop teaching on this. I've got a whole syllabus filled. You're going to get probably at least one or two more weeks teaching on discerning of spirits and the gift of discernment because there's so much to cover. I want us recording this. If you want a copy of this, you can also you can watch it on YouTube. You can watch it on Facebook. I ask you to share this message, but we also are recording it. If you want to be able to play it in your car and listen to it over and over again or in your home, you can order the recordings. Just call the church office and we'll make sure we get you a copy. But we want the body of Christ. Listen, we're not coming back from this COVID. We're not coming back from quarantine the same way we went in. Oh, Jesus came out of the wilderness filled with the power of the Spirit of God. I want to pray for you right now, wherever you are, put your hands up and just let me release this over you right now. Father, I pray for the body of Christ. As we are living in the last days and we are your disciples, Lord, Father, that you would release, impart, teach, train, equip, and anoint your people with the gift of discernment and discerning of spirits. Let us come up higher to a whole new level that we have never walked in before, knowing the days and the times that we are living in, that they are short, that the enemy is raging, that the end time tactics of deception and doctrines of demons is being unleashed, that the truth that we know of your word will rise up in our spirits, that we will be trained in the spirit of discernment, trained in the discerning of spirits to rightly divide truth from error, to rightly divide and discern what is being spoken from what is really behind what is being spoken. Father, that your bride, your church, more than at any other time in history, would rise up in this gifting in these last days with an overcoming and enduring spirit. Ooh. That she will see. I'll go into that next week. That she will taste, that she will discern, that she will smell, that she will feel the spiritual atmosphere around her and know how to respond, how to pray, how to command, how to declare, thus saith the Lord. Cause us to rise up stronger than ever before in this end time gifting and anointing. I bless your people in Jesus' name. Amen.
Silence every lie. No
Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for your word, Lord, that's gone forth this morning, Lord. Lord God, it will continue to resonate in the ears of your people, Lord God. Father, that the word will speak to them when they rise up. That word will speak to them as they walk along the way. That word will speak to them as they lay down. Father, that word will not leave us, Lord, but it will speak to us. It will open our eyes, Lord God. They will walk, Father, not as unwise, but as wise, discerning the times and seasons that we're in, Lord God. Father, we thank you and give you all the glory right now. In the name of Jesus our Lord. And the saints of God said, amen, amen, amen. Be blessed, everybody. We'll see you on Thursday night at Mark and Melissa's with John. And next Sunday, be sure to tune in. God bless you. We love you. Amen.